Hi there, and welcome back. In this video today, we're continuing to talk about accrual accounting and the reasons why we have to make certain adjustments in a period. So today we're going to talk about fixed assets, or in other words, property, plant, and equipment, and our depreciation entries that we have to make. Without further ado, let's get started. And welcome back. Today we're going to talk about depreciation. Now, when we were talking about in a previous video about adjusting entries that have to take place because of the fact that we do accrual accounting and because of the matching principle and the revenue recognition principle, we have to make sure that certain adjustments are made, and depreciation is one of those. So anytime we have property, plant, and equipment, you can think of those as land or buildings and equipment, or you will often hear this called fixed assets. These are typically very valuable assets that need to be depreciated over time. And one thing to note, that actually calculating depreciation amounts is a subject that we'll cover in later videos. So let's walk through an example. We have XYZ Company has purchased a delivery van for $45,000. Each month, the delivery van needs to be depreciated by $625. So what is the journal entry to adjust for this month's depreciation expense? Let's walk through our thinking process. Has a financial event taken place? Yes, it has. What accounts do we use? We will use an account called accumulated depreciation. I've abbreviated that here on the screen, as you can see. Accumulated depreciation for our delivery van. So a company could have lots of these for different types of assets they have. And the other one is depreciation expense. So do we have more or less accumulated depreciation on our delivery van? We have more. And do we have more or less of depreciation expense? We have more. So now let's check our logic. Our journal entry would be a credit to accumulated depreciation delivery van. And the reason for that is that we are using a contra asset account, which I talked about in a contra accounts video. And that contra account has a normal balance of a credit. So in order to have more of the accumulated depreciation for the van, we would have to credit that account. And we will debit depreciation expense. As an expense classification, its normal balance is a debit. So to have more of an expense, we would debit that. So yay, the logic works. And we're always so grateful when that happens. So to recap this, our fixed assets, or if you will, property, plant, and equipment, they will typically depreciate over time. And each month, we have to make adjusting entries to account for that depreciation expense. And with that, that's our recap for today, and I will talk to you later on.